We are here with Rami Khoury, renowned journalist and a member of the Assam Faris Institute for Public Policy at the American University of Beirut. He will be presenting this week, talking about youth in the Middle East and the opportunities for them and how entrepreneurship can help unleash the potential in the community. Thank you for joining us, Rami.
Thanks for having me.
What are your impressions so far of the event? It's early days, I know.
Well, it's very exciting, a lot of people, and what's interesting is that there's so many different sectors represented. It's a great chance for people to learn from each other.
I think that's a problem with entrepreneurship. I think people sort of have certain associations or connotations with entrepreneurship, saying it's about inventing things or it's about technology. But really, it's actually more about how you conduct business as much as anything. It's not about the business that you work in.
Yeah, I would even say it's more than that. I mean, one of the lessons we've learned from leading a major research project for the last 2 years on youth in the entire Arab world, we're doing this with UNICEF, AUB, and our many partners around the region. The most important thing we've learned is the dynamism that is inherent in what young people are doing across so many sectors. So it's not just business entrepreneurship, it's cultural, it's academic, it's sports, education, in so many different fields, media.
Yeah.
And I think this is the really huge new development which has not been properly documented or harnessed and channeled, this amazing force of probably 40, 50 million young people across this region no longer accepting to be constrained by the limits that adult society has put on them. Historically, they've broken out of these shackles, and it's a huge force that is still in the early stages of manifesting itself.
Through this research, are we now seeing a sense of optimism in the Middle East? Are we seeing a sense of optimism that young people in the region can actually meet their ambitions and their goals through their own endeavors? Has that, say, changed from maybe 20 years ago?
I would say yes, generally. What's interesting, surveys that are done across the region by Gallup and Silatech and other people repeatedly show an apparent contradiction, which is that most young people have a sense of skepticism in that they feel that they're not really going to get ahead unless they have the right connections and the right wasta and they know the right people or they come from the right group in their society. But despite that, there is this extraordinary insistence on working hard, being educated, getting trained, getting experiences, and they expect that their life is going to be better. So I think the optimism is there. Part of it is just genetic, and youth, young people tend to be optimistic. But I think more important is that young people understand better than anybody else in this region how the constraints that have defined society, political, economic, cultural, religious, security, media, whatever it is, the constraints that have defined society for the last half a century in the Arab region are slowly loosening, and there's tremendous opportunities, and the web and new media are just one manifestation of this. But so it's this incredible sense that people can actually change their lives for the better if they take the initiative, and they're starting now to figure out how to do that.
If we look at the region as a whole, from Morocco across to the Arabian Gulf where we are now and up to the Levant, are there differences from the survey and the research, are there differences from region to region in how the youth see their own opportunities and future?
There are, and it depends a little bit on their particular circumstances. For instance, you have societies like Lebanon, Palestine, Iraq, Sudan, Yemen, that are caught in armed conflict, chronic conflict. So that makes certain constraints. The major factor, I believe, is the environment. And this is where the governments are still important, huge players. The regulatory environment, the enabling environment that allows young people to actually get out there and do something if they wanted, whether it's form a company or open a website or start a non-governmental organization. So you have some societies that are more open and the more liberal, you find a lot more dynamism. Other societies that are still very tightly controlled by central governments, you find the opportunities are less. But even there, you're getting young people, sometimes with adults, pushing to loosen things up.
Looking across, I know it's difficult to generalize, but looking across the Arab world, do we feel as though that the education establishments are providing the right tools and skills and knowledge for young people to become successful entrepreneurs once they leave?
It's still early days in the education reform business. You know, many people have been doing educational reform going back 20 or 30 years. But the problem is that the educational reform is very slow, and the reform in education does not always match openings in society. So somebody might go to a good school and get educated in creative thinking and problem solving and taking initiative and things like that. But then they graduate from school and they go to work in a company or they work in the government. They find themselves in a situation where they can't use those talents, even if they've been able to garner them, harness them from their education. So the educational reform process is one piece of the bigger puzzle. You need to have that more open, liberal, pluralistic mechanism in society that allows young people to be creative and to take initiatives and not to be constantly constrained.
So the role of the government, it's not a case of government staying out of the business environment, a traditional laissez-faire approach that would be advocated in, say, America. You believe that government can play a role in actually creating the framework through institutions and through funding projects and that kind of thing to actually help this?
Yes, I think the governments have a really important regulatory role and an enabling role. They need to just make sure that the environment for businesses, for young people, for NGOs, civil society, foreign multinationals, whoever it may be, that the environment is an enabling environment, is open, and most importantly, makes people feel that there's a sense of fair play and equity, that you do actually have a fair chance to get ahead if you work hard and you use your talents, that you're not going to be constrained simply because you're not from the right tribe or the right political group or you're not connected, which is what a lot of young people are concerned about. So governments have an extraordinarily important role in playing that regulatory role. And I think you're starting to see it in some areas like telecommunications, transport, other competitive businesses where the government have opened up the field and stayed in the background. Private initiatives have really moved very quickly.
And we've seen some very positive signs across the region as well. I mean, obviously, I mean, countries that we both know well, like Jordan, have allowed that to happen. We're even seeing countries with a previous history of being slightly more closed, like Syria, really embracing technology and telecommunications to try and provide this framework, this more relaxed regulatory framework. These have got to be positive signs.
Well, they are positive, and they are very different across the region. You mentioned Syria and Jordan, for instance. Those are two very good examples. You have it all over the region, Morocco, Egypt, the UAE. Everybody, to some extent, is opening up and liberalizing. Partly it's because the governments simply don't have the money to keep providing the welfare kind of state services that they did for two generations, from the 1940s to the 1980s. They just don't have the money, therefore they've got to open up. What they're trying to do in most cases is open up, liberalize, tap the resources and the energy of the private sector, civil society, and other groups, but they're trying to open up in a way where they don't completely lose control. And this is really a fascinating process to follow. It's a bit like the Soviet Union back in the 1980s with Gorbachev.
Yeah.
They opened up and then, you know, things then took a
things accelerated from that point.
And many Arab governments are worried about that. They don't want things to get completely out of hand. And it's a reasonable concern, I think. So I think the critical element now is for the private sector, NGOs, civil society to partner, work closely with the government, make it clear that there has to be a partnership in society,
sure.
But also make it clear that the old days when the governments controlled everything and what people read and what people said and what people did, those days are over.
Finally, when are you speaking? When can we catch your presentation?
I have a mentor session tomorrow around 11, I think, on Tuesday, and then I'm speaking around, I think it's 2:15 or something like that, on this whole issue of what I've learned from studying youth with our many colleagues around the region, what we've learned studying youth in the Arab world in the last
Fantastic.
Few years.
Fantastic. We look forward to it. Thank you very much indeed for your time, Rami Khoury.